people, over 2 billion, that are unbanked or underbanked. We often think in the first world, hey, everyone's got a bank. Well, not true. A lot do not have it, and it's not economically viable for many banks in a traditional sense to do that. Now, couple that with another technology that's out there that we know about, we've had for quite a while, cell phones, mobile phones that people have, and they're able to charge it with minutes every month and put it on there. Well, there's a company out now that has said, hey, these people, these billions, literally billions of people that don't have a bank, but they do have a cell phone, could possibly get together if we use this wonderful thing called blockchain also. That company is called BitMinutes. And the CEO, Tom Meredith, is joining us right now today from his offices there in the Atlanta area. Tom, good to have you with us today.
Hi, Terry. How are you?
Doing fine. I'm really excited about what you're doing here because it seems like what you've done, you took the existing condition of over 2 billion that don't have a bank or underbanked. You take the cell phones that they got with already paid for minutes that are there. We've got some assets, blockchain, you stirred it together and you got some magic. Tell us a little bit about that magic and what you're doing there at BitMinutes.
Yeah, what we've done is we've been focusing on how to create an electronic cash system for many years. And in the process, we came across tokenization around 4 or 5 years ago because our friends at Visa and MasterCard were now encrypting their technology and sending it over their networks to try to reduce fraud and are getting hacked. So we've been doing tokenization now for many years, and we saw the fact that people were using prepaid phone time already today. Approximately 4 billion people are buying and selling minutes on a call it a gray market area. So we saw this opportunity to create the tokenization work we've done with money transfer, which we've done for a number of years with a large bank in Africa, to take that same token and turn it into minutes or money depending upon the use case. So you could send the token as prepaid time the way people do, but doing it on a universal basis by taking some global standards out of the ISO system out of Switzerland and be able to run on the existing Swift and MasterCard standards that we've been working on. So we came up with a token that could go either on the banking system or it could be used as prepaid minutes by 4 billion people. So the magic number is 4. It's taken us around 4 years to get here. We can send prepaid time or cash to 4 billion bank accounts or 4 billion cell phones. So the BitMinute kind of acts as the glue or the interface between the traditional banking system, the Swifts of the world, the MasterCards of the world, which we've been on for a number of years, but also over the Ripple and Ethereum networks using this ISO standard. So that's all the geek talk. But bottom line is we've got a use case that will permit people to send money or minutes to 4 billion phones for free. So think of it as a global Venmo or a global free Western Union that can go directly into the phone and be used immediately for airtime as these 4 billion people use today, unlike we hear in the United States. So it's called a prepaid system. You have to prepay your minutes before you use them. So the minutes, BitMinutes, can be used as prepaid minutes or as money for any one of these 4 billion phones.
Yeah, that opens up a lot of possibilities for many great opportunities for people to go ahead. Matter of fact, in doing my research for this, I saw you talked about the global value transfer market is over $600 billion and over $60 billion in the fee revenue, and that's according to the World Bank. Tom, I don't know about you, but where I grew up out in the country, we called that serious money. And it seems like you're putting that combination together so it is a viable need that people have to help on the social side, but also on the business side. Talk to us a little bit about that beautiful blend that you've got going on there.
Yes, so many countries rely on money coming back home from people leave the country because they can't find a job. They send the money back home, and that money that comes back represents a significant portion of the GDP of many of these countries. So that is roughly two-thirds of $1 trillion a year gets sent back just from individuals. So it's a bunch of small pieces of money, call it $100, $200, $300 on the average. But you're talking about literally hundreds of millions of these transactions to get up to two-thirds of a $1 trillion market. It's funny, the prepaid cell phone market is also roughly two-thirds of $1 trillion as well. So in that $600 billion range. And that's where, again, we see this congruence of people sending money back home where we could save them approximately 10%. And the fact that there's approximately 4 billion people that have roughly $10 what we like to say, trapped in their cell phone because they have it in their phone as prepaid minutes, but they can't use it. So again, the concept is we could send a BitMinute token to any one of these 4 million phones and convert it into the prepaid time today, two-thirds of a trillion-dollar industry, or turn it into cash, two-thirds of a trillion-dollar industry as well. The key about the money transfer side of it is the fact that since we're doing it for zero, there's no cost. We literally can deposit that money into a bank account at zero cost to the consumer, which is, again, as you pointed out, roughly a 10% fee. So we're freeing up the money that's in the phone to be used as for lending and to send money, and we're also taking those transfer fees down to zero.
I like it. It sounds really good. Well, let me get real nitty gritty here and go down into it. This is to help real people. Real people, say in a third world country, we've got a single mother who's taking care of her children, and now she's got this phone, and suddenly she can get $10, $20, which might not seem like a lot to those in the first world, but in that country, it means a lot. How do you see people, how do you envision people using that $20 or so to get out there and to really generate money in a business?
Yeah, this is, we're a bunch of back-end guys, but we've, again, had this token technology for 4 years, so we're way ahead technology-wise, but it doesn't really matter. There's a lot of ICOs out there today that are coming up with new ideas, and boy, that sounds great, and geez, in a perfect world, and if everyone jumped on our new blockchain, you know, we'd all make a lot of money and sail off into the sunset. But that's not really the issue here. The issue is you've got to find people that actually want to use whatever it is your token does. So again, if you're going to go after a mass market in particular, you got to keep things really simple. So that's why BitMinutes is nothing but a chunk of prepaid minutes that can convert on exchanges into cash. And again, because we've spent 4 years building out these global networks for clearing and settlement, we can deposit that cash with very, very low friction because again, we're hitting these ISO standards. So again, that's the architecture. So why does mom in Mozambique or mom in Mexico or mom in Mogadishu, what does she need? She needs access to capital. And these people are unbanked, not because they're bad credit risks. It's because they don't have access to capital. And that's strictly because the banks don't want to lend to them. A bank cannot make a profitable loan at $5, $10, number one, because of their overhead. Number two, they don't have the distribution in the villages where the money is needed. It's $10, $20 to buy a couple more chickens, to buy a goat, whatever it is. And these are still very agrarian societies, but still very cash-based. So if mom doesn't have a credit history and mom doesn't have access to credit in order to build a credit history, she's out of luck. So the two primary use cases that we have for BitMinutes are one, free global money transfer. So think of it as a global Venmo or a free Western Union, but it's even more convenient because we could send it right to mom's phone in Mexico. But that is to get the money into the country. The real key, we believe, and we're just about to release this product, we've got a major partner in Central America about to go with this, is that we can establish mom's credit and build her a credit history by giving her a $5 loan just for showing up, having a phone, having a valid ID. She doesn't need a business plan. She just needs $5. So the concept is she buys $5 of BitMinutes. She has to have skin in the game. But these BitMinutes can be used for her phone at any time. So she's buying something that we know that she can use and she knows that she can use. Because we envision her buying a minute or two of BitMinutes and seeing if it really does work on the phone. And when she sees that it does, she says, oh, so now I get it. I buy $5 a BitMinutes. That goes into my account, but I can't touch it. And then you're going to lend me $10 a BitMinutes. Yes, that's the process. So mom walks in with $5 into the corner prepaid phone seller, which is on every street corner in every village and every town on the planet, except for the United States. So she walks in with five. She buys $5 a BitMinutes. She owns them, but she's taking out a loan for $10 a BitMinutes. So she walks in with $5, she walks out with $10, and we'll do that all day long to establish mom's credit history. So that's the actual mechanics. It can't get any more granular. And then what we're doing is we're talking to global telecommunication vendors to make this BitMinutes as part of their their product mix so that they can get into the financial services industry. So very, very interested from some very large telecom players.
Tom, Meredith, this is amazing. What you're doing is you're really solving a major problem. I mean, you're giving them something, not just cute little trinkets or something else that we see with a lot of other coins that are out there, but you're giving something they can use, like money. They get money, they do it, they're building their credit, and you're using blockchain so you can take care of the concerns of, well, how do we know this has happened or that? How can we have trust, et cetera? You're complying with all the know your customer rules that are out there so that banks know what's going on because of it. You put a great combination of it together. Somebody wants to find out more about it, where do they go, and any closing words that you have for us today?
BitMinutes.com is our website. We're always making adjustments to make it easier to use, but I would say at the end of the day, there's a lot of interesting ICOs out there, and this is a brand new world, but I do believe that the ICOs that will gain traction are going to be the ones that really solve a need, which we're trying to do. And if we do this right, I think we can create the world's first truly global currency that isn't, let's say, dictated by any one particular country. So, we all like to see the U.S. dollar is obviously wide use every country on the planet. But this is something we believe that can really become a true global currency for billions of people and make their lives better in the process.
This truly is groundbreaking and a wonderful opportunity for many people. Tom, we appreciate what you and your team are doing and putting that together. Thank you.
Great. Thanks a lot. Appreciate it, Terry.
And for those of you that are watching this, think about what you see is happening right now. Get over there, check it out yourself. You'll see the white paper. You can read about it. It's got some really good information, and see if this is something that could work for you as well. On behalf of BitMinutes.com, I'm Terry Brock. Thank you for being here.